Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Freedom, which is a distraction blocker, which is designed to help you keep focused when you're doing a specific activity. Now, this piece of software is available on pretty much all devices, and we'll be taking a look at how effective it is today, also a little bit about the features and how it specifically works on the Mac edition, which is replicated pretty much across all of the desktops. So without further ado, guys, let's dive into Freedom. So guys, just before we dive into this video, I just want to thank Brain FM for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. For those who haven't checked it out yet, Brain FM is a music application that uses AI to help choose the most effective music for a range of different scenarios. Now, if you haven't used it yet, you can choose a range of different options from sleep to meditation to focus, and you can use it during those times. And it's quite useful because what it does is it actually helps you to focus even further. So when you're using like Freedom, you could use this alongside it to help your sessions go even more effectively. Now you can try it for free on Android and iOS using the free 5 sessions link below. But if you really fancy and love it when you use it, do check out the code KEEP for 20% off. I was playing around with this one when I was in San Francisco, as I mentioned in yesterday's feature, and I used it to have a really good old sleep, and also using it during a few of my focused work sessions too, especially when I'm editing a video as well, or doing something like an article to really retain the focus. So guys, big thanks to Brain FM for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. So guys, let's dive into Freedom. I have my Mac open here in front of me, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually dive into the application. Okay, so I have downloaded Freedom and I'm just gonna show you, it will appear in the area. So for example here, I can click in Freedom. Freedom is available on the menu bar on the Mac, so it will be up here as this mini butterfly. Don't get it confused for the likes of the Ulysses logo. Okay, so they have an iOS version, Android, Mac, and Windows, and it does allow you to essentially block the entire internet. Now, a lot of the time, the distraction we face during our days is from the websites we use on a day-to-day basis. Now, you can use the application for 7 free sessions, and I'll include the link in the description below. But during that, you get the opportunity to try out pretty much all the features, and there is a premium. And the premium is priced at $6.99 a month, but if you want to go for the yearly plan, it's $29 per year. So at the end of this video, you should get an idea of the features, how it actually works, and whether it's a good investment for your workplace or work productivity. So as you can imagine, this is the Mac version. I'm going to demonstrate how you go about using this. So as you can see here, I've got obviously my Francesco Mac connected. I'm going to go ahead and press launch dashboard, because essentially this takes me to the website, which has a bit of a like an overview of all the devices you use. So I haven't actually connected it to my iOS device. I wanted to do a separate feature on that to show you what actually and how that works, because I think that's a bit more effective. You can see here that you can actually start a session from here. So you can start a specific timer. You can choose what to block, whether that's actual Mac applications or all website, and on the devices you use it. So for example, if you wanted to block like all buying habits for an hour on specific devices, you could do. And as you can see here, I've made what's called block lists. So as you can see, you can create a block list down here. And you can choose a certain sites that you want to reduce blocking. So for example, you can have anything from games to sports. You could just block LinkedIn for a couple of hours, or you can choose the specific website that distracts you most. Maybe you want to put in Reddit in there or something like that, or even Slack if you want to have a bit of time off. Now, you can choose the actual time that you choose. You can actually set one for later. That's actually only available in the premium, but that actually allows you to set up a, for example, scheduled one. So for example, if you know you're going to be writing, or you want to set something very specific up, then you can have that going. Now you can actually add a session, you can add a recurring session. As I said, that's available in the past the free session. Actually, it's not included in there, but it actually allows you to set up a recurring one. So if, for example, if you wanted to have a routine hour to spend not touching any websites, to be writing in your own book, then you can do so. Now, locked mode, again, is available on the upgrade. I'll go through the full pricing when we finish, but I'm just going to go back to here, and this is my sessions and what I've done before. So you can see session history. I had a 31-minute session a couple of weeks ago, and you can write your accomplishments here and what exactly you blocked. So I blocked all the websites and apps on this Mac, and I accomplished edited a full YouTube video. And again, you can see the same. So you can see here, over the last 7 days, I've saved 26 minutes with Freedom, apparently. And that's aimed to help you keep a track of how well you're doing. Now, if I go out of this, I'm just going to minimize this for now and go back up to the area here. I can go ahead and select devices I'm going to be actually blocking on. I can actually select the block list I want to choose. So for example, in this case, I'm going to block all websites, block all app use, and that means that it won't connect to the internet, and also block the buying and distractions online. Now, if I go ahead, I can start a session based on any bit of data. For example, I can have a custom length, which I could choose to be like, you know, like 45 minutes specifically, and press start a session. Now, once I've started a session, obviously everything gets blocked, and you can see up here, I've got 45 minutes left on this one. And it goes about blocking everything. So for example, if I went over to Chrome and I decided I'm gonna be like, okay, I'm gonna go to facebook.com. You can see here it blocks it automatically, and a message should appear saying, take a deep breath, you are free. So it has a sort of website blocker automatically installed, and it will reroute to that website. Now, if I just go ahead and cancel this one, if I wanted to cancel, actually, I don't think there's a cancel button. I think you are sort of locked in. I haven't actually tried canceling a thing before. Okay, that's a good indication that it's quite an effective way of doing it. For example, if I wanted to manage the blocked desktop apps, I could specifically block a certain set of apps. Now, this is really useful because if I, for example, I'm going to be using like Bear as like my writer and I wanted to write an article in that 45 minutes that I'm doing it for, I could keep that one unblocked. And if I wanted another one, you know, blocked, I could certainly do that. Now, you can only save this before the Freedom session starts, so that you're not going and changing the settings during your session, because that would be sort of defeating the point of the concept. And you can only do that with the Freedom exceptions here. So, for example, you have to set this up, the websites that will not be blocked when you start. So the way you do that is just by hitting add a site, and you go ahead and add a specific one. So the one thing I actually haven't done is you need to be able to set this up, the exceptions list, and then actually go over to here and enable website exceptions. So for example, if you're a social media manager and you need a specific couple of pages, or you want to be able to get access to your My Pages Facebook, then this is probably the best place to set up. So make sure you're enabling web exceptions. Now, in terms of the overall experience, when I was using this during the sessions on the Mac, it blocks all the apps out that I didn't want to distract myself, which is really useful. And for example, if I wanted to go over to this manage block desktop apps list, you can see that I've specifically got like calculator blocked. And if I go up to the search bar and type in calculator, and I specifically try and open that, it automatically shuts the app down. So I actually can't access it. It like shows it for a second, but then decides to like force close it, which is quite a good technique. But sometimes it's sort of like, if you forgot that you're blocked apps list, you'd probably be like panicking whether your actual devices were probably working. Now, overall, I think this application's most suitable, and I recommend it for people who are really getting distracted by social media. And I would like to do a full review of the iOS application, because once you connect this with your iOS and Android apps, I think this would be really effective. But the way that you can select your devices and block certain things is quite nice. Now, the full feature set includes a lot more. For example, block the entire internet, the Mac app, Windows, iOS, and Android apps. You get session history, allowing you to see more details, which we demonstrated earlier, session annotation, website exceptions, something called locked mode, which actually gives you sort of locking so that you don't make any edits during the feature or end the session. Also recurring scheduling and advanced scheduling too. You also get Freedom perks and Windows website extensions as well. So there are a huge bunch of benefits for this one. If I go over to the area that I wanted to create, so if I go back up here and press launch dashboard, then I should be able to get access during this period of time. And you can see my current work session here. So it gives me a bit of an idea on the pricing, but if I go to upgrade, I can give you a bit of an idea on what that looks like. Now they actually have a discount at the moment. It just appeared here, $64.50 for forever access to Freedom, and that's using May 2019. I'll try and include that in the description. That wasn't planned, that was just actually just came up. They one of the things I have to note is the Windows website exceptions isn't currently available, so that's just something to note. But probably what I recommend doing is trying the free trial first, setting up maybe 7 sessions of work that you'd be doing a specific activity like editing, setting up all your settings so that all the right websites are deblocked and all set up, and then giving it a go and actually making sure and seeing if it's a good investment. I recommend actually testing it, seeing if it works for you. Because some people are pretty good at being able to set up a habit of them not touching it, or maybe even like putting a jar in your room of just having like, okay, I'm going to put a pound in there every time I go on Facebook or something like that. Or telling a spouse that they'll donate to a bad charity if you if they do this, and being honest about that. Or having like an accountability buddy, showing your website history, for example. I don't know, but if you don't see like Freedom beneficial in those 7 sessions, then necessarily it might not be for you. There are other sort of mini distraction blockers which I'll probably be reviewing soon, so it's probably worth checking those out as well. So guys, hopefully you found this review useful of Freedom. I'll probably be doing the iOS app soon because I want to do a separate feature on it. But all the information's available at freedom.to, so you can check out all the details there. But I really appreciate you stopping by today. If you're brand new to Keep Productive YouTube channel, hit subscribe. It'd be absolutely fantastic to have you in the community. If you enjoyed this video and found it valuable, hit the like button. And if you'd like to comment below with your own experience of Freedom, please do. Or any other distraction blocker, because it's good to know what other solutions are out there. Anyway, guys, huge thanks, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers.